This story about Matthew Shepard had such an impact on so many people worldwide, and that's been really powerful to encounter people who were so deeply affected, as I was, to learn about Matthew Shepard, and to know that they still carry that, some of the feelings and the effect of that impact 18 years later, 19 years later, 20, very, very powerful. And then I brought my own intention to this, which was to just let this come from the heart. Really simple, you know. I wanted to write a large form musical piece that was related at least to what we call the oratorio in classical music jargon. Just that this is something that, this is one of those long form stories. And I always loved those as a young music student growing up, and as a choral person, I just love these big stories.
These are the things that stray and pass.
There was something that was amazing about seeing all these people get to come together in a room and witness and experience the telling of this story, and then all the energy from the responses in the room, and then it was held by music that was just the right container for it. So I wanted to relate it to that form of the oratorio, but I also just wanted to write a big song. You know, it was kind of the sense, I want to write a song for Matt. One of the sections of text, the lyrics from one of the movements, this chant of life cannot be heard, it must be felt. And it's about this, you know, you can name it a thousand things, it probably has no name, but it is this chant of life. That's what I'm interested in us getting back to when we experience this piece together, is this movement of life that threads through all of our lives. And it is what we share in common. It's as common and shared as our breath is. And that's, I do feel people opening up to that and kind of a remembering, and aha, oh yeah. And then that makes me very happy.